All right, so today in the shop we have, can't tell what it is from the front there, it's a 2003 Honda Odyssey minivan. This is my wife's van, and this summer we're going to be towing a car to the, up to the Tacoma area and into the islands, the San Juan Islands. And we're going to have a load of people and gear, and we're going to really load this thing down. So what I wanted to do and talk about today is this new black thing right here. It's called a transmission cooler. And it cools the transmission oil. This one is called a bar and plate series cooler. This Honda Odyssey is equipped with a 3.5 VTEC engine and a 5-speed automatic transmission. They call it the glass transmission. Ever wonder why anybody would nickname their transmission glass and how it's down in there? It's because they have a lot of failure problems. And part of the problems is the transmission works so hard to tote this somewhat heavy 5,000 pound rig around with all your gear and towing a car, even though it's a small car. You gotta give the transmission a chance. So they didn't come with a factory cooler. I should say they didn't come with a factory cooler like this. They do have a factory cooler that goes in the bottom of the radiator. So what I've done here, I've taken the front of the van apart, and it looks terrible, but really the whole thing just comes apart like a zipper. There's about 10 little plastic bolts on the bottom that just kind of pop off. There's a few plastic little bolts on the top here, a screw here and on the other side. And basically the whole bumper just falls right off and it looks like this. I did have to take this headlight out on this side. And the only reason I had to do that was to gain access to the back of the air conditioning condenser here. And the only reason I need to do that is I need to lift it up just a little bit so that I can get the nuts on the back of these little zip ties that hold the transmission cooler on. Now, this transmission cooler is rated for 20,500 GVW. That's 20,500 GVW. This van's never gonna tow that, but I did get the extra size one. I'll show you the box here, transmission oil cooler. So it's a series 13503, I'm sorry, series 8000, part number 13503. I got it from etrailer.com with free shipping, and it's rated at 20,500 GVW. The cooler is 8x11, and I thought that would be, has a cool little thing here, tells you how long your transmission fluid will allow your transmission to last, to help us out on our trip this summer. So a couple of tips and tricks for somebody doing this as a DIY job. It's actually not too bad. If you're handy at all, you can do it. The hardest thing, I think, is to get these little pokey zip tie things in without, what you want to do is you want to press them in between, you've got tubes and fins, and you want to hit the fins, not the tubes. If you poke the tubes, you'll let the gas or the fluid out. And you don't want to poke through too far to puncture your radiator on the backside. That's the hardest part so far. Everything else is pretty easy. I did take and I bent this sheet metal out just a little bit because I've got to get the hoses to go and wrap around there. So I don't like doing that, but that's the only way to get the hoses to go around there. And I mounted it here because it's in direct front of everything. The radiator fans, which are back here when the air conditioning is on, will help cool the transmission cooler because it'll be drawing air through. And there's a lot of grill space area that's open here underneath the bumper, so it'll get a lot of nice fresh air. I thought about putting it in the, I guess it would be the fog light vent here, but there was just no way to secure it. The best thing to do, and I know it's intimidating, is just to pop the bumper off. Really, it doesn't take that long. Just be careful. Don't break the plastic clips. Take your time. It took me approximately 45 minutes to get the bumper and the headlight out. It's not that bad. And then you just have to figure out which is the pressure and which is the return. And you want this in the return, basically the cool side, if you're going to use the factory cooler in tandem. And you can do that actually by starting up the rig and seeing just carefully and quickly where the fluid is flowing. So that's next up. So I'm going to turn the camera off. I'm going to reassemble and check it and show you what it looks like when the grill and bumper and everything is back on. Okay. Okay, as you can see, we've got our bumper back on our van here. This is after our transmission cooler installation. And what I did, I should say, let me back up here. So the bumper cover basically is held on the top by all these little clips right here. I think there's about 10. And there's a couple screws on each fender well. And then underneath, same type of thing, lots of little clips. It seriously is easy. This whole job took me 3 hours, and that includes changing the engine oil and servicing the transmission. And you can see I'm adding transmission fluid here. I'm using MaxLife. It's full synthetic because it has the Honda Acura AZ, what's it, ATF-Z1 specification, which this transmission calls for, and it's synthetic. So hopefully with the synthetic and the cool transmission cooler, let's see if we can find it in there. See the top of it right there, that shiny part? Let's get down a little lower here. There it is. You can see it off to the side there. There's the hoses that run back. So yeah, you can't tell it's there. Obviously, it's hidden from view. It gives the transmission a little bit extra capacity, fluid to help cool, as well as you know, it's a cooler that actually works. It's an air-to-air cooler. What I forgot to mention was the brand name and where to get it. So it's a Durali, I think that's how you pronounce that, transmission oil cooler. That is the part number. I got it on eTrailer.com. It was $55, free shipping, and it's the Series 8000 plate and fin. 11 inches across, 8 inches tall, good for 20,000 GPW plus. I don't think we're going to be towing anything that heavy. But like I said, these transmissions in the Odysseys are glass. And anything you can do to help them out can help them out. So there's your tech tip and trick for the day. 2003 Honda Odyssey transmission cooler install. Thank you for watching.